Hi guys.
In today's video, we will see how pruning is effective in respiratory disease such as COVID-19. So what is pruning? Pruning is a medically accepted position in which patients are supposed to lie down on their chest and stomach or on the sides. So basically, the patient is lying face down. Let's see why pruning is important and what is the mechanism behind. Here you can see I have drawn lungs. There are 300 to 500 millions of small air sacs present in the lung. They are called alveoli. I have drawn a simple picture of alveolus and associated capillary. In normal situation, oxygen comes into this hollow cavity of alveolus and diffuses into the capillaries. And carbon dioxide released from the capillaries into the alveoli to be breathed out. In COVID patient, virus attacks the cell present in the alveolus, which release inflammatory cytokines and cause inflammation. Inflammation of the capillaries cause increased vascular permeability. That means capillaries become leaky. So fluid comes out of the capillaries and start accumulating around the alveolus. Here you can see the space between the alveolus and the capillary is filling up with fluid. Gradually, the alveolus will also fill up with cellular debris, purulent materials, and fluids. That will decrease the surface area for gas exchange. So the incoming oxygen will not be able to diffuse into the capillaries, which will eventually decrease the oxygen saturation in blood. Now let's discuss why prone position is important. Here you can see two types of lying positions. One is supine, where patient is lying flat on his back, and the other is prone position, where the patient is lying on his belly. Here are two cross sections of the lungs showing the shape and size distribution of the alveoli in both supine and prone position. This side is the ventral portion and this side is the dorsal portion of the lung. Now multiple things are happening here. First one is the pressure of the lung tissue itself due to accumulation of fluid and inflammatory products, and the gravity and pressure of the other organs. So in supine position, if we see, the alveolus are in normal size on the ventral portion, and gradually the size is getting reduced if we go down towards the dorsal side due to the compression and pressure. One more thing you can see that the distal portion is bigger than the ventral portion. So the number of alveoli are more towards the dorsal segment. However, due to the compression and fluid accumulation, the available surface area for oxygen exchange becomes very less. Here, gravity complicates the thing by pushing blood downward towards the poorly oxygenated alveoli in the posterior lung and creating a ventilation perfusion mismatch. This mismatch is thought to drive rapid deterioration of patients. Now, in prone position, the ventral portion of the alveoli will be compressed. But as we discussed that the ventral portion has less alveoli than the dorsal portion. So more alveoli will be available on the dorsal portion for oxygen exchange. Even the compression of the other organs can be avoided.
Now let us see who are the ideal candidates for prone lying. Proning is required only when the patient feels difficulty in breathing and the SpO2, that is the oxygen saturation, decreases below 94. In such cases, regular monitoring of SpO2 along with the other signs like temperature, blood pressure, and blood sugar is important during home isolation. So for self-proning, you will need 4 to 5 pillows or rolled sheets, one pillow to be placed below the neck, one or two pillows below the chest, two pillows below the shins to support lower legs and to elevate toes. First is prone position, in which you can lie down on your belly for 30 minutes to 2 hours. The pillows should be placed properly and there should not be any direct pressure on your abdomen or any compression. Any abdominal compression prevents the free movement of diaphragm. It is especially important in patients with obesity. Next is lateral position. First turn towards your right side and lay there for 30 minutes to 2 hours. Weight should be on your hip and shoulder. Pillows to be placed under your head, back, and small pillow between the flexed knees, as shown here in the demonstration. Then sit upright, with head being elevated to 45 to 60 degrees as shown here. Use two pillows for your backrest and head and a small pillow below your knees for elevation. Use a pillow to support your arms. After this, lie down on your left side and follow the previous instructions. you have to change the lying position in every 30 minutes. Now, here are the few things to keep in mind while self-proning. Avoid proning for an hour after meals. Proning should be done only when it feels tolerable. One may prone for up to 16 hours a day in multiple cycles. Keep a track of any pressure sores or injuries, especially around bony prominence. You can use pillows or rolled sheets to release the pressure and increase the comfort. So, what is the importance of prone lying? It relieves the pressure on various parts. Prone positioning improves ventilation and stimulates circulation in your lungs. It keeps alveolar units of the lungs open and helps in breathing comfortably. It promotes physiological function of the lungs. Proning should be avoided in conditions like pregnancy, morbid obesity, deep vein thrombosis, a patient who has a history with spinal instability, increased intracranial pressure, hemodynamically unstable conditions like hypertension and cardiopulmonary diseases, thoracic injury, or recent abdominal surgery. So that's all you need to know about self-proning. Share this video with your loved ones and don't forget to subscribe our channel.